Thanks to Linode Cloud Computing for supporting this episode of SciShow. Go to linode.com/scishow to learn more and get a $100 60-day credit on a new Linode account. The deep sea is the largest ecosystem on Earth, and one of the most inhospitable. Its frigid water and bone-crushing pressure make it not only extremely hard to live in, but also hard to study. Scientists don't even have a complete picture of what creatures live down there, or how they survive. But one team of biologists found a creative way to explore some of these questions, with the help of three dead alligators. Dead stuff is an important part of the deep sea diet. That's largely because no sunlight reaches down there, so plants don't grow. And the vastness of the deep sea means that it can be a while before a hungry creature finds a living thing to eat. So many deep sea creatures are scavengers, feeding on dead plants and animals that sink down to the sea floor. For example, fallen whales become a smorgasbord for all kinds of deep sea life. They're so large and take so long to eat that creatures actually set up camp on the carcass and transform the whale's body into its own whole ecosystem while they feast. Studying these scavengers in action is a great way to explore the inhabitants of the deep sea. So scientists have dropped the carcasses of various animals, like whales, dolphins, and even cows, into the ocean to study the creatures that come and eat them. All this led one Louisiana biologist to wonder if dead alligators might be an important part of the food chain deep in the Gulf of Mexico. Even though alligators live in freshwater rivers, those rivers all eventually lead to the ocean. And researchers have observed plenty of gators making their way to the Gulf, dead and alive. Now, alligators may not be the size of whales, but they can still tip the scales at hundreds of kilograms, so their carcasses could make a hearty feast on the seafloor. So the biologists worked with a team of other researchers to design a study. Their plan was to drop some alligator carcasses into the Gulf and see how things played out on the seafloor. They were interested in seeing how an ecosystem that's often starved for resources would react to the arrival of an alligator carcass. Past studies had mostly been done with the carcasses of marine mammals, so the team was curious if deep-sea creatures might also rely on these non-marine reptiles as a source of food, even considering that alligators are covered in tough armor. They were also interested in seeing what sorts of animals showed up to dine, and if these scavengers would just feast and take off, or if they'd turn the alligator into a long-term habitat, just like a fallen whale. So in 2019, in the name of science, the research team tied weights onto three dead alligators and dumped them into the Gulf of Mexico. Then the researchers visited the carcasses several times over the next 2 months using a remotely operated vehicle with a camera attached so they could watch the feast unfold. And a diverse array of deep sea creatures showed up. Larger scavengers turned up first, including crustaceans known as isopods. They're related to those roly-poly bugs that are common in gardens, except they're bigger than your average chihuahua. Some of these larger creatures were lucky enough to be nearby when the feast arrived, and as they dug in, their feeding activities likely alerted other animals in the area. And gradually, other creatures drifted in. By the end, the dinner guests ranged from those giant isopods to tiny bone-eating worms. The researchers found that the scavengers did not seem to care that the gators were covered in armored hide. They were edible, and that was good enough for them. They got through the alligators' tough skin easily enough and had their feast. These animals ate quickly enough that the alligators didn't become the hosts of entire ecosystems like whales do. But considering how many Louisiana alligators may end up in the Gulf, it's possible that these animals are an important food source on the seafloor. Researchers also speculated that while most deep-sea creatures are used to eating marine carcasses, alligators might not be such an unusual feast for them. Many of the creatures found scavenging carcasses in the deep sea evolved millions of years ago, when marine reptiles, not marine mammals, were common in the ocean. So they may have actually evolved to eat the bodies of reptiles. In areas around the world where alligators or other large reptiles are common, this study suggests that these reptiles are an important part of the marine food chain. This understanding also helps scientists make predictions about how the climate crisis will affect the inhabitants of the deep sea. As the ocean warms, acidifies, and rises, marine ecosystems will change, and the type of life that finds its way to the seafloor may change as well. So the better we understand the creatures that live in the depths of the ocean, the better we can understand the impacts on them. For now, whatever changes come, this type of research gives us rare insights into one of the most unknown places on our planet. This episode of SciShow is supported by Linode Cloud Computing. Linode provides access to services that you're probably already using, from streaming to storing files on the internet. And they know that cloud computing can sound confusing, so they have award-winning professional customer service representatives to answer your questions 24/7, 365 days of the year. You can get started fast with Linode's online dashboard and start small to get only the services that you need now. And when you're ready to scale up, they have the global infrastructure to grow with you as your ideas take off. So to see all that Linode has to offer, click the link in the description or head to linode.com/scishow. That link will give you a $100 60-day credit on a new Linode account. Thanks to Linode for supporting this video, and thank you for watching.